Thank you. Your Excellency, Ms. Monique Kaguriza, Commissioner of the Republic of Rwanda to the Republic of Zambia, allow me to recognize our ministers, members of the clergy, led by Bishop Joshua Banda. Let me recognize our ministers, Your Excellencies, ambassadors and commissioners, senior government officials present, representatives of international organizations present, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, colleagues from Namibia, allow me to say all protocols saved. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct honor and privilege to represent the government and the people of Zambia at this year's 25th commemoration of the genocide against Tutsis in Rwanda. This tragic event that occurred in 1994 left a permanent stain on the history of Rwanda and Africa. On this solemn occasion, we remember the 800,000 plus Tutsis and some moderate Hutus that lost their lives in just 100 days of the genocide. And an estimated 250,000 women and girls that were raped and killed. We are particularly saddened by the estimated 300,000 children who also lost their lives during the genocide. And we wish to honor those who showed tremendous courage in risking their lives to save others. Your Excellency, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the tragic occurrences and loss of life during the genocide not only negatively affected our brothers and sisters in Rwanda, but also affected our region, the African continent, and the international community as a whole. We, the Zambian people, stand in solidarity with the people of Rwanda in the condemnation of such acts wherever they occur in the world. Your Excellency, distinguished guests, the consequences of the mass atrocities and human rights violations on such a large scale are still evident today. In this regard, as we commemorate and remember those who lost their lives during the genocide, as well as those still suffering from the consequences of its aftermath, we should be reminded with great certainty of our obligation as Africans to bind together in order to solve the numerous challenges that we face as a people. Let us be reminded, distinguished guests, not to resort to violence, but instead look to dialogue and reconciliation to resolve our differences. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I therefore wish to echo the words of His Excellency, Mr. Paul Kagame, President of the Republic of Rwanda, and I quote, "We cannot turn the clock back, nor can we undo the harm caused. But we have the power to determine the future and to ensure that what happened never happens again." End of quote. Indeed, only by working together and learning from the past can we build the Africa we want. It is for this reason that I wish to take this opportunity to commend the government and people of the Republic of Rwanda who have shown remarkable strength, courage, determination, and resilience to emerge from this dark period in an era of tremendous economic, political, and social progress. Under the leadership of His Excellency President Paul Kagame, Rwanda has since become one of the fastest growing economies in Africa. And it is my government's desire to continue enhancing the relations and cooperation shared between our two countries for the development or key sectors in both our economies. I further wish to take this opportunity to commend His Excellency President Kagame and the government of Rwanda for the extraordinary leadership illustrated as chairpersons of the African Union for the year 2018. During Rwanda's tenure, Africa has indeed learned a great deal from Rwanda in our joint efforts towards the attainment of an autonomous and accountable African Union. Your Excellency, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, in conclusion, as we take time to honor the victims and survivors of the Rwandan genocide, we will continue to draw inspirations from Rwanda as the people who triumphed over evil and summoned the courage to bring out what is good in humanity. My government, under the able leadership of His Excellency President Edgar Chakwarungu, will continue to support this spirit of unity as we endeavor to attain a more peaceful and prosperous Africa.